this is how the Naked palette looks like. You get a variety of 12 different neutral shades. It just kind of goes from like light to dark. And you do get a mixture of matte and shimmer colors, and so that's kind of nice. And it also came with this free eyeshadow brush and a free mini primer potion. As far as the pigmentation of the eyeshadows, I would give it a 9 out of 10. They are pretty pigmented on their own, but I would still recommend using a primer just because it's going to help your eyeshadow to last longer and it's going to reduce creasing throughout the day. But my favorite colors from the palette definitely has to be this one right here. It's called Virgin, and it's not completely matte, but it's not like very shimmery either. It's just kind of a nice color to use for like highlighting your brow bone. And then I also really like this one right here called Naked. And this is like a light brown and it's a matte color. I like using this one for blending out harsh lines. This one right here called Buck, it's like a medium brown and it's also one of the matte colors. This is really nice if you want to create like a natural smoky eye look without it being too dramatic. This is really nice for placing in the outer V of your eye. And then I also really like using this one right here called Toasted. This is one of the other shimmery colors, but it's really nice for placing like all over your eyelid. To be honest, I haven't really played around too much with any of the other colors. You do get like a mixture of some golds right here, and then you get like a shimmery black and a gray. But to be honest, I was a little bit disappointed with the palette when I got it because at the store, I mean, it looked really pretty and a lot of people raved about the palette, but I just find that it's a little bit too shimmery for my taste. Like if you look at this one right here, it's called Sidecar. Like you can kind of see like the flecks of sparkle in it. And I don't know, I just don't really like using a lot of eyeshadow that has like glitter in it. And these ones right here, like they're shimmer, but then like they're not like as crazy as the other one. Like these two right here, like you can kind of see like the glitter in it. And so, I believe it was like $50 to $52 for the palette. So, I mean, for the price, it's pretty good because you do get, you know, 12 different colors. But, I don't know, like, I'm kind of at a crossroad with this palette because I don't find myself reaching for it every day. If anything, I probably use Virgin and Naked the most, but I don't really use any of the other colors. And so, I guess it's kind of just a hit and miss. I mean, if you like shimmery colors, and I would definitely, you know, recommend this palette because you will enjoy it. But if you're someone like me where you don't really like too much of like the shimmery color, then I would actually pass on the palette because you're gonna find yourself only using like two of the colors. And so, and then the next thing that I will be reviewing is the Urban Decay primer potion. And I started using this one like 3 years ago when I first discovered it, and it's been my favorite one ever since. This is just the regular primer. It's like a nude color, and Urban Decay does have like two or three other different finishes that you can get the primer in, but I really like the nude one just because it goes well with everything and it's gonna help to even out your skin tone as well on your eyelid. But this is just like the mini version, but then I used to have the larger tube that I finished already. But this is how it looks like. The applicator, it's like a doe foot, and so it makes it easy to like grab the product out of the tube and to apply it onto your eyelid. It's very creamy and it's super easy to blend, so I really like this primer. I've tried like two or three other different primers, but I always go back to this one. And I believe for like the larger size, it's like $16 to $17. And the last one that I will be talking about is this palette right here. And this is how it looks like. It just comes in like a really cute packaging. My friend actually got me this for Christmas, and so I don't know if it's still available, but if you're interested, you can check out urbandecay.com and see if it's still available. But this is how it looks like on the inside. It comes with 9 different colors, and similar to the Naked palette, you get a mixture of a couple matte and some shimmer. Right away when I saw the palette, I was really drawn to this green and this blue. I just thought that the colors were just really pretty. And once again, you know, like with this palette, it's very shimmery. And so it is kind of hard for me to wear the colors like on a day-to-day basis. I don't find myself reaching for this palette at all unless if I'm doing like a photo shoot or something, then I'll go and grab the palette. But I don't know if it's just my skin type, my skin color, or my eye shape, but I just find it very difficult to wear color eyeshadow, and especially when they're shimmery too. So I don't know, I'm kind of like mixed feelings about this palette just because I really enjoy all of the colors, and you know, when I'm just kind of playing around and dressing up for fun, then you know, like I'll play around with the colors, but then like on a day-to-day basis, like I can never wear like that green or that blue out in public. And so like this bottom row I really really like, but like they're a little bit too shimmery for me, and so it makes it harder for me to pull off. But I mean, a lot of you out there, you know, I know that you guys can wear shimmer eyeshadow, and so if you're, you know, someone who really enjoys like the glitter and stuff, and then you'll probably have a lot of fun using this palette. But for someone like me who leans toward more matte colors, then this palette can be a little bit difficult to use. But I do enjoy the pigmentation of the eyeshadows. You don't have to press them very hard to pick up a lot of the color. So like this one right here and this blue one. Like the colors are just so gorgeous. So yeah, like I really enjoy the color range in this palette, but just for like a day-to-day use, it's not ideal for me. But like I said, I don't know if it's still available. It might even be a limited edition palette, but go onto the website, you know, check it out, and you might actually find other palettes that you might like too. So hopefully this review was helpful, and if you guys have any questions, please feel free to comment below, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And I do also have a giveaway that I'm doing, and so check out my other video to see more information about that. But until next time, I'll see you in my next video. Bye!